Assalamu alaikum, welcome to VetLec. Today I am going to discuss the anatomy of liver. I shall discuss the anatomy of bovine's liver, equine's liver and canine's liver. Liver lies inside the intrathoracic part of abdominal cavity and it lies just caudal to the diaphragm and it is present more on the right side of the body. The liver is divided into four lobes and these are left hepatic lobe, right hepatic lobe, quadrate hepatic lobe and caudate hepatic lobe. There are two surfaces of the liver and these are diaphragmatic surface and visceral surface. Diaphragmatic surface is the convex surface of the liver which is in contact with the diaphragm and it is also known as parietal surface. The visceral surface of the liver is in contact with the abdominal viscera and this visceral surface is concave in shape. On the visceral surface of the liver, the area where blood vessels and nerves enter the liver is called porta. So that area is called porta. Caudal vena cava from the heart also runs through the dorsal portion of the liver and then moves to the abdomen and then legs. Now let's discuss the lobes in bovine's liver. Liver in the ox is located on the right side of the median plane of the body and it is present in an obliquely downward and forward fashion. So the right hepatic lobe faces the right lateral abdominal wall such that its parietal surface faces dorsally and somewhat laterally and it is directed cranially. In short, the right hepatic lobe is present cranially near the right lateral abdominal wall and its parietal surface faces dorsally and somewhat laterally. Similarly, the left hepatic lobe is located towards the median plane and it is directed somewhat ventrally and therefore the liver of the ox is present in an oblique fashion inside the abdominal cavity. So the parietal surface of the right hepatic lobe is present dorsolaterally and the left hepatic lobe is present or it is directed somewhat ventrally and in this way liver lies in an oblique fashion. The quadrate hepatic lobe is located on the inferior surface of the right hepatic lobe and the caudate hepatic lobe is present between the left and right lobes in an anterior and dorsal location. So the caudate hepatic lobe is present between both right and left hepatic lobes dorsally and somewhat cranially. The caudate lobe of bovine's liver is further divided into two parts and these are caudate process and papillary process. The remaining three lobes that are right hepatic lobe, left hepatic lobe and quadrate hepatic lobes in case of ox are undivided. So only caudate hepatic lobe is divided into caudate process and papillary process. And the caudate process of the caudate hepatic lobe of ox also contains renal impression for the right kidney. So this renal impression is formed by the right kidney on the surface of visceral surface of caudate process of caudate hepatic lobe. Liver is fixed in its position by means of ligaments. Now let's discuss the ligaments of the liver. The ligament which is present between the diaphragm and parietal surface of the liver is called coronary ligament. Similarly, a ligament is also present between left hepatic lobe and quadrate hepatic lobe and this ligament is called falciform ligament. On the parietal surface of liver along with the falciform ligament, there is another ligament which is called teres hepatic ligament and this ligament extends between the liver and diaphragm and finally it extends to the linea alba. So the falciform ligament is present between left hepatic lobe and quadrate hepatic lobe and along with this falciform ligament on the parietal surface of the liver, teres hepatic ligament is also present which extends between the liver and diaphragm and then extends to up to the linea alba. Between the right hepatic lobe and diaphragm, there is another ligament which is called right triangular ligament and similarly between the left hepatic lobe and diaphragm, there is left triangular ligament. Between the right kidney and caudate process of the caudate lobe of liver, there is a ligament which is called hepatorenal ligament. So hepatorenal ligament, as the name indicates, it is present between the right kidney and caudate process. Gallbladder in ox is present between the quadrate hepatic lobe and right hepatic lobe. Between the left hepatic lobe and quadrate hepatic lobe, there is another ligament which is called round ligament. This round ligament is actually the free end of the falciform ligament, and it connects the liver with the umbilicus in fetus. So it has only function in fetus, and in adults it has no function. Now let's move to the liver of dog. There are four lobes of the dog liver, and these are left hepatic lobe, right hepatic lobe, quadrate hepatic lobe, and caudate hepatic lobe. Left hepatic lobe in case of canines is further divided into two parts, and these are left lateral hepatic lobe and left medial hepatic lobe. Similarly, right hepatic lobe of dog is also further divided into right medial hepatic lobe and right lateral hepatic lobe. The caudate hepatic lobe of dog is further divided into two parts, and these are the caudate process and papillary process. The caudate process of the caudate hepatic lobe of liver of dog also contains a renal impression for the right kidney, while the papillary process is located inside the lesser omentum of the stomach. The fourth lobe, which is the quadrate hepatic lobe, is undivided in case of dogs. Now let's talk about the ligaments of the liver in dog. The hepatorenal ligament is present between the caudate process and right kidney like other species. Round ligament, like in the ox, the round ligament in dog is also present between the left medial hepatic lobe and quadrate hepatic lobe, and it has only function in fetus, and in fetus it is actually the umbilical vein. The falciform ligament is actually a part of the distal mesentery of the stomach, and it moves to the internal surface of the linea alba up to the umbilicus. So it extends between the liver and umbilicus. The coronary ligament is present between the parietal surface of the liver and diaphragm. Between the left lateral hepatic lobe and diaphragm, there is a left triangular ligament, and between the right lateral hepatic lobe and diaphragm is right triangular ligament. There is another ligament which is called hepatogastric ligament, which is present between the liver and stomach. Gallbladder in case of dog is present between right medial hepatic lobe and quadrate hepatic lobe. Now let's move to the liver of horse. Liver of horse is located cranially and caudal to the diaphragm, like that of ox and dog. Liver of horse contains same four lobes, like left hepatic lobe, right hepatic lobe, quadrate hepatic lobe, and caudate hepatic lobe. But in case of horse, right hepatic lobe, quadrate hepatic lobe, and caudate hepatic lobes are undivided, and only left hepatic lobe is divided into left lateral hepatic lobe and left medial hepatic lobe. The caudate hepatic lobe of the horse is undivided, and it contains only caudate process, and that caudate process also contains renal impression for the right kidney. In the caudate hepatic lobe of liver of horse or equine's liver, there is no papillary process. If we talk about the ligaments of the equine's liver, then it contains same ligaments like dog and horse, dog and ox. Like hepatorenal ligament is present between right kidney and caudate lobe. Coronary ligament is present between the diaphragmatic surface and diaphragm. Left triangular ligament is present between left lateral hepatic lobe and diaphragm. Right triangular ligament is present between right hepatic lobe, right lateral hepatic lobe, and diaphragm. Hepatogastric ligament is present between the lesser curvature of the stomach and liver. The falciform ligament is also present between the quadrate hepatic lobe and left medial hepatic lobe. And this ligament starts from the liver up to the diaphragm and then moves from the linea along with the linea alba up to the umbilicus. So first this ligament extends between the quadrate hepatic lobe and left medial hepatic lobe up to the diaphragm, and then it moves caudally along with the linea alba up to the umbilicus. In this way, at the free end of falciform ligament, there is present a wide structure which is called round ligament. And this round ligament moves along with the falciform ligament up to the umbilicus. This round ligament also originates from the quadrate hepatic lobe and left medial hepatic lobe of the liver along with the falciform ligament, and it is present at the free end of the falciform ligament, and therefore it moves along with the falciform ligament from the liver up to the diaphragm and then up to the umbilicus along with the linea alba. Before birth, this round ligament is actually a vein, but after birth, there is no function of this vein, and therefore it turns into a ligament. This round vein changes into a round ligament. One important thing to note in the liver while discussing the anatomy of the horse liver is that there is no gallbladder in the liver of horse.